Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ, and today I'm going to talk about setting yourself up for investing success for the new year and how to start a habit of investing by automating your investments. And so today I'm going to talk about how you can use the app M1 Finance, which is an investing app that has a lot of features that allow you to automate your investing and also invest in fractional shares. So as I mentioned, just as a quick overview, M1 Finance is an investing app. It allows you to invest in fractional shares, and it also allows you to do automatic deposits that will automatically be invested into the stocks that you choose within the M1 Finance app. Now you can set up weekly or you can set up monthly deposits, and then those deposits, as long as they're over $25, they will be automatically invested into the stocks that you choose on the app. Now, if you want a general overview of just how M1 Finance works, I do have a review of the M1 Finance app, and also have a tutorial where I walk step-by-step through how to use the app. So make sure you check those videos out. I'll have a link below in the description. But today, what I'm going to talk about is M1 Plus. Now with M1 Plus, it gives you a few additional features, like adding the M1 Spend checking account, adding a few additional automation features with M1 Invest, and also gives you the option to borrow against your investments with M1 Borrow. Now there are certain features that you don't get with the free version of the M1 Finance app, and with the M1 Plus, it is usually $125 per year in order to have these additional features that I'm going to talk about in the video today. But from now until the end of January, if you do sign up with M1 Finance, if you're a new user and you sign up for M1 Plus, it will be a free trial for you for a year. And not only that, but in addition, if you deposit at least $1,000 into your M1 Finance account, you will receive a $30 bonus once you make that deposit. And so if you'd like to get started with M1 Finance today, make sure you use my referral link, which will be provided in the description below, as well as the top comment. And now I'll talk about more of the details about M1 Plus and how it can help you with automating your finances to get you started in the new year. Next, I'm going to talk about M1 Spend, which is M1 Finance's checking account. Now, one of the most important features, in my opinion, that you get once you do sign up for M1 Plus is that you can now set up what they call smart transfers. So when you have money in your M1 Spend checking account, you can set up automated transfers that follow specific rules to either transfer money into your M1 Spend account or to transfer money from your M1 Spend account into your M1 Invest account, as well as transfer money from your M1 Invest over to your M1 Spend. Now, you can only use this smart transfer feature if you have money in your M1 Spend account. And so if you only have M1 Invest and you just use it for investing, you don't use the checking account, then these smart transfers you wouldn't be able to use. But also, if you don't have M1 Plus, you wouldn't be able to use these. Instead, you would just transfer money from your external bank account directly into your M1 Invest account. Now, here are the three options that you have with the smart transfer and how this would be helpful for you if you're looking to automate your investing, and just to add a couple additional layers to your automated investing. And so the first option they have is called Spend Over Balance. Now with this option, once your M1 Spend, once your checking account has reached a certain balance, let's say that threshold is $1,000. If your M1 Spend account were to go above $1,000, then any money above that would be automatically transferred into your M1 Invest account and then invested into the stocks that you own within your M1 pie. And so if you used M1 Spend as essentially a savings account instead of an actual checking account, and you always wanted to keep just $1,000, or maybe you wanted to keep a month worth of expenses, or maybe 3 months of expenses, then anytime you put additional money into that account, if it's over the threshold of the amount of money that you want to save, then you can have it automatically go into M1 Invest, and then your money is invested instead of just sitting and only earning the amount of money that you get from the interest rate that M1 Finance provides. So what you can also do is set up direct deposit from your job. And so with M1 Spend, if you happen to use it as your main checking account, you can have all of your deposits going into your checking account. Any additional money that does not go towards your bills, does not go towards groceries, things of that nature, once it reaches whatever threshold that you choose, then that money will be invested into stocks. Now, the next option is the Spend Underbalance Transfer. Now, with this option, you would do the same. You would essentially pick a certain threshold that once your account gets under a certain amount, let's say you don't want it to be under $1,000, then you can set up this automatic transfer so that any external bank account that you have connected to M1 Finance would automatically transfer money into your M1 Spend account. That way, it goes back up to the threshold that you choose. And so this way, you always have a minimum amount of money in your M1 Webull and Spend account. Of course, you want to make sure that whatever external bank account that you have connected to it, that always at least has the same amount of money that you want to keep the minimum threshold at for your M1 Spend account. But this would also be a great way if you happen to use your M1 Spend checking account for actual daily purchases, and you wanted to keep a separate savings account with an external bank, then whenever you got below a certain threshold that you choose, you can have money automatically transferred from your savings account into your M1 Spend account. And so let's say if you had an emergency and you had to spend $500 on something unexpected, and you always have money saved in another account just for those specific reasons in case you do have an emergency, instead of having to wait to transfer that money from that savings account into your M1 Spend checking account, you can just spend the money from your M1 Spend checking account, and then it will automatically transfer the money from whatever external bank that you choose. So I think that's a really cool feature for making sure that this checking account, if you use it for your everyday expenses, making sure that it stays at a certain threshold, whatever dollar amount that you choose. Now, another option that you have also within this spend under balance option is that you can actually transfer cash from your M1 Invest account into your M1 Spend account. And so let's say you already have a lot of money in your investments with M1 Invest, and you keep a certain amount of cash in there, or if you get a lot of dividends from the stock holdings that you have within M1 Finance, you can actually have those dividends essentially be transferred from your M1 Invest account into your M1 Spend account. And so in a previous video, I actually showed an example of how you could use dividends to pay for your cell phone bill or pay for other bills that you have. And if you haven't seen that video, I'll have a link in the description below so that you can check that video out. And so this is one way that you can actually automate that process. So that way that any dividends that you're receiving within your M1 Invest account, if you don't want them automatically reinvested into the stocks that you own in M1 Invest, then you can just increase the threshold that you have automatically set up for investing. And then that way you have a larger amount of cash held into your M1 Invest account. That way you can automatically transfer those dividends and that additional cash into your M1 Spend account once it gets below a certain threshold. And so I think that's a really cool feature that you get out of the M1 Plus version of M1 Spend and the M1 Invest. And now related to that is the next feature, which is the Invest Over Balance. As I mentioned, within the M1 Invest portion of the app, you can set a certain balance to where if, let's say you have $1,000 worth of cash sitting in your M1 Invest account, in your actual investing part of the app, anytime it reaches over that threshold, whether it's you putting additional money in the account or whether it's your dividends coming in from the stocks that you own, then you can have that additional money automatically invested into your M1 Pi. And so you can really see how all of these different smart transfers can work together to make sure that the money that you have in your invest account, in your spending account, and also coming from your external bank accounts, that they're working together automatically. And so it's not something that you have to check on a regular basis to make sure that you have enough money or that you're automatically investing any additional cash that you have that you just have sitting. And so in order for that to be triggered, the additional amount above whatever threshold you choose, you need to invest at least $25 in order to make a purchase with M1 Finance. However, you don't need to put $25 in an individual stock. So you can have up to 100 different stocks or ETFs within the M1 Pi that you create. But as far as the individual stocks within your Pi, you only need at least $1 per stock in order for M1 Finance to actually make a purchase of that stock. And so if you had exactly 25 different companies owned within your M1 Pi, then you could essentially buy all of those stocks, at least $1 worth of every stock within your Pi. And of course, if you have more than $25, then it will evenly distribute it based on the way that your Pi is structured. And so you don't even have to worry about, you don't have to worry about actually going within the M1 Finance app and actually choosing which stocks it's gonna go to. It's gonna automatically invest based on the settings that you set for your M1 Finance Pi. All right, and that's it for the smart transfer portion or the options that you get when you sign up for M1 Plus. So one of the differences between the basic M1 Invest account and the additional features that you get via M1 Plus is that M1 Finance usually has one trading window. So essentially any money that you put into M1 Invest, whether it's your deposits or whether it's dividends that you're getting from the stocks that you already own within M1 Finance, you only have one opportunity per day. The market opens at 9:30, and usually there's a trading window sometime between 9:30 and 11 a.m. when M1 Finance actually makes the buys and the sells for any stocks that you want to buy or sell. And so if you're a day trader, this isn't really a great option if you're looking to buy and sell multiple times throughout the day. But if you're a long-term investor and you're only looking to buy and hold, then this doesn't matter as much for you. However, with M1 Plus, it does give you a second window at the end of the day, at the end of the trading day, which closes at 4 o'clock. It gives you that second opportunity to buy or sell more of the stocks that you own. Now, in addition to that, if you do happen to be a day trader or maybe a swing trader and you want to buy and sell on the same day, if you have M1 Plus and you have at least $25,000 in your account, then you can use both of those windows. You can use the morning window and you can use the evening window. If you have more than $25,000, which is the minimum that you need in order to be a day trader, essentially, because there are rules against how many times you can buy and sell in the same day. If you don't have $25,000, then you're only allowed to day trade 3 times within a 5-day period. But once you have over $25,000, you can do it as much as you want. And so if you happen to use M1 Invest for your day trading, then you could buy in the morning and then you could sell again at the end of the day. But like I said, for most people, if you're a buy and hold investor, then this doesn't matter as much to you. You can buy or you can sell. It just gives you an additional opportunity if you wanted to buy more at the end of the day, or if something really crazy was happening or you had an emergency and you didn't want to have to wait that extra day, you would have the end of the day trading window in order to buy or sell more. And so that's the one major difference with the M1 Invest portion of the M1 Finance app. The next option or the next feature that I'm going to talk about is the interest rate that you receive in the M1 Spend checking account. And now again, this is a checking account. It's not a savings account, but you can essentially treat it like a savings account because right now it's giving you a higher interest rate than many of the high yield savings accounts that I've talked about in the past. And right now that's 1%. Now 1% is not a lot, but at the current moment with the Fed, who has reduced the interest rates significantly over the last 2 years, and they've stated that they have no plans on increasing that interest rate until at least 2023, getting 1% interest from a checking account is actually really good. And so even if you don't use this as your main checking account, you can use this essentially as a savings account for the next year, and you're getting a 1% interest rate, and you don't have to pay the normal $125 for M1 Plus in order to have this feature. And in addition to that, with the checking account, you can actually earn cash back on your purchases. And so if you do choose to use it as a regular checking account and you're using it for your normal purchases, you can get 1% cash back on all of your purchases. And now there are many credit cards that give you 1% cash back. There are even some that give you 2% on every purchase that you make, no matter the category. But even a 1% cash back card is really good, especially when you consider that not only are you getting 1% cash back on your purchases, but you also get 1% cash back on any cash that you hold in to the account. And so if you want something really simple, if you're a person that doesn't like to use multiple credit cards in order to earn cashback rewards, which I talk about in some of my other videos as well, then this is an app that you can use that will really help to simplify and really consolidate many of the things that you already do, like having a checking account, a savings account, cashback cards, and your investment app. And these are all within this one M1 Finance app. Now, the next feature is M1 Borrow. And this you can actually use without having the M1 Plus as well. But when you have M1 Plus, you actually get a lower rate on the loans that you get, which you are essentially borrowing against the investments that you have within M1 Finance. And so with M1 Borrow, you can borrow up to 35% of the amount of money that you have invested in M1 Finance. But in order to use M1 Borrow, you have to have at least $10,000 in your M1 Invest account in order to make that loan, essentially. And even without M1 Plus, you can borrow at a rate of 3.5% versus the 2% when you have M1 Plus. And considering that the Fed has no plans in changing the interest rates within the next 2 years, interest rates not only affect your savings accounts, but they also affect credit cards and they affect the rate of loans that you get. And so their rates, although it is a variable rate, it is going to stay low for a long period just because the Fed has no plans to change those rates anytime soon. And so while I don't necessarily recommend that people borrow against their investments, if you did need to borrow money, getting a 2% interest rate on money that's essentially money that you already have is actually pretty good. It's actually lower than even mortgage rates, which are some of the lowest interest rates that you can get for a loan. It's definitely lower than your credit card if you needed to borrow money. It's also lower than any personal loans that the majority of banks are going to offer you. And of course, the reason that you're getting this lower interest rate is not only that the Fed has lowered interest rates so low, but also because your investments are the actual collateral for the loan. And so if you don't pay back the loan, then they're just going to sell your stock in order to get their money back. That way they're covered, and so they can offer you a lower rate based on already having the collateral within that account. Now, some people, of course, would consider borrowing against your investments really risky. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for everyone. So, of course, you know, make your own decision on whether it will be worth it to you or whether it's too risky. Because if there were a big downturn in the market, let's say it went down 35% like it did last year in 2020 in March, then there is a possibility that you may have to sell, or they may automatically sell your stock in order to get the money back for that loan and also to cover your bases so it doesn't continue to go lower. And essentially, you may not even have enough money to pay back the loan, at least not based on the investments in your account. And so, of course, keep that in mind as far as they can make an automatic sale of your investments if your account were to get too low and they see it as a risk in not getting their money back for the loan. So those are the perks that you would receive if you signed up for M1 Plus. Like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, they do have a 1-year trial as long as you sign up before the end of January. And in addition to that perk, if you deposit at least $1,000 in your M1 Finance account, whether or not you sign up for M1 Plus or not, then you will get a $30 bonus for making that $1,000 deposit. Oh, and one last thing I forgot to mention, they also have a bonus for account transfer. And so if you were to transfer your investments from another brokerage account into M1 Finance, they offer a bonus for that as well. In order to get a bonus, you'll need to transfer at least $10,000 into the account, and that will give you a $40 bonus. And then if you have a lot of money that you want to transfer, like $2 million, then you would get a $3,500 bonus for transferring that money over to M1 Finance. And so whether you have $10,000 or $2 million, there's an option in between. You would get at least $40 or as high as $3,500 if you're a big baller and you have $2 million. But even if you're a new user and you're not transferring any money from another brokerage and you're not depositing $1,000 to get that $30 bonus, you can start with as little as $100 to open your M1 Invest account. And if you wanted to open an IRA with M1 Finance, then you would need at least a $500 deposit in order to start an IRA. And then once you get started, all you need is a minimum of $25 to continue to add more money into your IRA or into your M1 Invest brokerage account. And so with as little as $25 a week or $25 a month, you can start investing for your future. You can start your new year off right by automatically investing in the stock market, automatically investing for your retirement, or automatically investing to start on your path of financial independence. And so in my follow-up video, I'm going to talk about the Roth IRA that I created specifically to share with you all who are my followers and subscribers. If you're not a subscriber, make sure you hit the subscribe button below. But I'll go into more details about how even just $50 a month or $100 a month over time can grow into hundreds of thousands of dollars or even into $1 million if you were to max out your Roth IRA. All right, thanks for watching this video. Let us know what you think about it in the comments below. If you like the features of M1 Plus and how it can help you with automating your investing, is it something that you plan to use while you have the option for this trial period? Or even if you miss out on the trial period, is this something that you would use with the current $125 per year price point? All right, thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I really appreciate it. If you're not a current subscriber, you're not a member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you need to do is hit the subscribe button down below, hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video just like this. All right, thanks for watching. Have a great day.